conference by Economic Affairs Secretary Shaktikant Das.
Countries can keep evaluating and reviewing the situation, and as and when the requirements meet the needs of various sectors, measures are being announced. For the farming community, especially for the farmers, already measures have been announced facilitating cash drawal, higher cash drawals from against crop loan sanctions, higher cash drawal from their sale of agricultural produce, similarly higher cash drawal in the APMC markets for registered traders, and similar other measures have been announced. Cash also has been made available. The new denomination notes, 2000 rupee and 500 rupee notes, are also being made available, have been made available in 1.55 lakh, 1,55,000 post offices across the country to disburse cash to especially the rural people. Now, today the government has again reviewed the situation. I mean, it's a continuous process because you keep getting representations. And government has decided on certain measures to especially keeping in view the requirements of the farmers, for the benefit of the farmers. And secondly, for the promotion of digital economy, for the promotion of digital transactions in the country, for greater and faster proliferation of digital transactions in the country. Now, consequently, the NABARD, for the facility for the, you know, for the benefit of the agricultural operations during the current Rabi season, and especially for the benefit of the farmers, NABARD has sanctioned a special limit of 21,000 crores of rupees to be sanctioned to the district central cooperative banks. And as you know, almost more than 40% of the small and marginal farmers get their crop loan credit, get their agricultural credit from the cooperative institutions. Out of the total institutional credit which flows to the agricultural sector, to the farming community, out of the total credit that flows from institutional sources, more than 40% of the requirement of small and marginal farmers is from the cooperative credit structure. So therefore, the sanction of 21,000 crore limit by NABARD to the district central cooperative banks will enable the district central cooperative banks to pass on, to sort of grant funds, to sort of pass on these funds to the primary agricultural cooperative societies. And the primary agricultural cooperative societies network, the PACS network, will get activated and will meet the crop loan requirement of farmers during the current Rabi season. So therefore, this measure will ensure a smooth flow of credit, unhindered flow of credit for the farmers to enable them to undertake their current Rabi operations. With regard to seeds, as you know, government has already announced certain measures that the old notes would be acceptable in the case of a seed purchase from certain government department and government institutional centers. And over and above these 21,000 crores, as and when additional limits are required, additional limits also will be sanctioned by the NABARD. Now, secondly, to ensure that the farmers get the credit, and also they get certain quantum of credit in terms of cash, by way of cash, because there are certain cash requirements for payment of wages, etc. So the banks, the NABARD and the Reserve Bank of India have been advised to make the required cash available to the district central cooperative banks, because typically the district central cooperative banks draw their cash from the currency chests which are managed and operated by the commercial scheduled banks and also by the state cooperative banks. NABARD has prepared a list of all DCCBs which require funds for sanction of crop loans in the current Rabi season. The list of such DCCBs and the quantum required by each of such DCCB has been given to the banks. They have been given to the NABARD, they have been given to the Reserve Bank of India, and the required cash will be made available. And the Honorable Finance Minister has also held a video conference with the Reserve Bank of India, with NABARD and all the banks day before yesterday, and has advised banks, RBI and NABARD to ensure that the entire, the crop loan sanction and flow of funds to the down to the primary agricultural cooperative societies, the entire operations, the whole chain of activities are carried on in a seamless and in a smooth manner. Then, as you are aware, the Reserve Bank of India has already announced certain relief for small loanees up to 1 crore. So that has already been announced, so I am not going into in detail. Now, the other decision which has been taken, and I must appreciate the role being played by the public sector banks over the last 10-12 days in dealing with the situation, in making the cash, in making the new currencies available to the public. I must also recognize the work being done by some of the private sector banks. The entire banking structure has fully geared up to meet the situation. And you are aware that so far as RuPay cards are concerned, the National Payment Council of India has already waived, waived the switching charges, and all the other charges on the RuPay cards have been already waived. Now, the public sector banks and some of the private sector banks, we have been talking to the private sector banks and some of the service providers who provide the switching services. They have agreed to waive the charges, the service charges on the use of debit cards up to 31st December 2016. In other words, the MDR charges on use of debit cards, that is RuPay cards, it was already done. Now on debit cards, the charges being levied by the banks and by the and the switching charges would stand completely waived. So there will be no charge on use of debit cards. The intention of this decision and the intention behind this gesture which has been made by the banks is to ensure greater penetration of digital transactions into our economy and to ensure that more and more people migrate towards digital transactions. And I take this opportunity to appreciate the gesture of the public sector banks and some of the private sector banks who have already agreed, and others are expected to agree and use their and issue their own circulars. Next point is with regard to the use of e-wallets, that is what they call as prepaid payment instruments, PPIs, or more popularly known as e-wallets. Already the Reserve Bank has announced certain relaxations yesterday, enhancing the limit from 10 to 20,000 in respect of individuals, and similar other limit enhancement in respect of merchants. So I am not going into it. Next point is that Indian Railways, 58% of the tickets being booked in the railway network are through e-ticketing, through online e-tickets. Now, the railways have also decided and have announced already yesterday that on 31st of December, the service charges on online booking of e-tickets will be completely waived up to 31st December 2016. So this is also another measure, another initiative taken to promote more and more digital transaction in our economy. You see, you have to keep in mind the whole background in which this decision to withdraw the legal character of the old 500 and 1000 rupee notes was done. One of the primary objectives, or one of the positive outcomes of this decision also, is that we expect large number of people to migrate to digital transactions. It is already happening. The public sector banks in particular have informed us that there is a great surge in demands for various kinds of prepaid cards, debit cards and impressed cards, and various for uses of the digital means and modes of payment. Now, in the same vein, the TRAI has also reduced the USSD charges from rupees 150 to 50 paisa per session. The announcement in this regard has been made by the TRAI yesterday. And not only they have reduced the USSD charges from 150 to 50, 1 rupee 50 paisa to 50 paisa, they have also increased the number of stages from the current 5 to 8. Now, we have to remember that these charges will be of great benefit, especially for undertaking digital financial transaction through feature phones. Now, these are not, we are not talking of smartphones. We are talking of feature phones, which are not smartphones. And in our entire telecom sector in the country, 65% of the total mobile phones used in the country, I repeat, 65% of the total mobile phones in the country are feature phones, which are not smartphones. And this waiver of the, you know, the reduction of the USSD charge of the by the TRAI has now also been matched by the telecom companies themselves to waive the remaining 50 paisa of the charges up to 31st December 2016. In other words, for all digital financial transactions which are being, which will be undertaken in feature phones, will have no service charge till 31st of December 2016. Another area which has also engaged the attention of government is to promote digital payments at the various at the various toll plazas and check posts. Now, the problem of check posts is being addressed in the context of the GST, in the context of introduction of the GST. Now, so far as the toll plazas are concerned, you know, various tolls which the vehicles are required to pay when they move on the national highways. So far as toll plazas are concerned, the Ministry of Road Transport and Highways are advising the vehicle manufacturers that in all new vehicles provide ETC compliant RFID facility. Now, the provision of ETC compliant RFID facility on all new vehicles will ensure payment digitally, the payment of the toll in a digital method, and also it will enable, you know, it will avoid the waiting time, and the vehicles will move seamlessly without having to wait at the check posts. So this is another decision which will improve the functioning of the toll plazas, will improve also the system of digital payments. And finally, all government organizations, public sector undertakings and other government authorities have been advised to use only digital payment methods such as internet banking, unified payment interface, cards, other enabled payment systems, etc., to make payments to all stakeholders and to their employees. At the point of disbursing of the payments, that is when payments are to be disbursed to various private agencies or contractors whom government departments or agencies or PSUs, when they make payments to private parties, at those disbursing points also, it will be necessary for the concerned authorities to provide an option for payment through cards, digital banking, unified payment interface, Aadhaar enabled payment systems, etc. In other words, the option of digital payments even to private parties will be mandatorily provided, will necessarily be provided. It will be an option which will be provided, and instead of issuing a check or a demand draft, you can make the payment through an online transaction. So all these measures of the government are essentially meant to promote digital penetration with regard to various kinds of transactions. The measures are also intended to help the farmers in the current Rabi season to ensure a normal Rabi crop, especially coming on the back of a good monsoon that we have. So these are the measures which I wanted to announce. The National Payment Corporation of India has been playing a very important role in promoting digital transactions. I have with me the colleagues of from the National Payment Corporation of India, who will just take a couple of minutes. If you can focus the camera, I would request my colleagues from National Payment Corporation of India to just show a small demonstration how the payments are facilitated through the mobile phone. And after that, I will address a few questions. I will reply to a few questions thereafter. निमिष नहीं, यहाँ हाथ में दिखा दीजिए ना आप, मोबाइल में लेके हाथ में दिखा दें,
कैमरा कैच कर लेगा ना यार
वो, कैमरा कैच कर लेंगे वो, मोबाइल में दिखा दीजिए आप,
मोबाइल में,
मोबाइल में दिखा दें,
मोबाइल.
I would request the cards, you know, cameras to please focus and please no conversation. I request you loudly.
Good morning.
बैठ जाओ. Loudly.
Good morning, sir. हम लोगों ने एक UPI जो Unified Payment Interface है NPCI ने develop करके सारे बैंकों को already दे चुके हैं. Already 20 बैंक इसमें pilot basis पे काम कर रहे हैं. ये जो demonstration है मैं आपको यही दिखाऊंगा. ये एप्लीकेशन डाउनलोड करके जैसे किसी का एक ईमेल आईडी होता है, पर्सनल ईमेल आईडी होता है, उसी तरह का सबका एक फाइनेंशियल आईडी हो सकता है. जैसे मैं अगर पंजाब नेशनल बैंक में अकाउंट होल्डर हूँ तो मेरा नाम के हिसाब से pushpanyar@pnb मेरा एड्रेस होगा. इनकी एड्रेस अगर dinesh@obcbank होगा और ये PNB से OBC हम लोग ट्रांसफ़र कर सकते हैं पैसा. और ये मैं ट्रांसफ़र भी कर सकता हूँ और पैसा पुल भी कर सकता हूँ. मतलब पहले आज तक जितने भी पेमेंट हुए हैं वो पुल बेसिस पे हुए हैं, मतलब हम लोग पैसा भेज सकते हैं. लेकिन ये पहला इंटरफेस होगा जिसमें कि हम पैसा मांग भी सकते हैं. तो ये हम लोग आपको दिखा रहे हैं कैसे हम लोग भेज सकते हैं पैसा. ये अभी ₹1 उन्होंने ट्रांसफ़र किया है अपने ICICI बैंक के ऐप से. Your transaction is successfully.
PNB दिखा
दीजिए. PNB
पजारा.
इसमें क्या है सर, कोई भी बैंक का ऐप आप डाउनलोड करके किसी भी अकाउंट से लिंक करके आप ट्रांजेक्शन कर सकते हैं और ये पैसा मांग भी सकते हैं. अगर मुझे उनसे पैसा मांगना है, पहले इनको डालना पड़ता था मेरा अकाउंट नंबर, IFC कोड. अभी उसके अलावा मैं सिर्फ एक SMS भेजूंगा कि मेरे को इतने पैसे दे दो, वो ओके करेंगे और पैसा मेरे पास आ जाएगा. तो ये एक चीज़ हम लोग अभी ऑलरेडी कर चुके हैं.
सर ये वेबसाइट होगी, कोई वेबसाइट होगी या कोई,
एक मिनट, ये वन बाय वन ये पूछ,
ये वेबसाइट होगी या कोई प्ले स्टोर से हमें कुछ डाउनलोड करना,
प्ले स्टोर से मोबाइल ऐप
क्या है थोड़ा सा वो बता दीजिए, डिस्क्राइब कर दीजिए कैसे करते हैं, कैसे करेंगे,
प्ले स्टोर से
नाम क्या है,
ऐप का क्या नाम, ऐप का क्या नाम
आपका, डिपेंडिंग ऑन द बैंक,
UPI यूनिफाइड
ऐप नेम इज
पेमेंट इंटरफेस,
जैसे PNB का दिखा रहे हैं अभी, इसका नाम है PNB UPI ऐप.
तो हर एक बैंक का अलग अलग होगा. आप अगर PNB पंजाब नेशनल बैंक के अकाउंट होल्डर हैं तो आपका वो अलग होगा. स्टेट बैंक ऑफ इंडिया का अकाउंट होल्डर है तो आपका अलग, SBI का जो है वो होगा.
उसी के बेसिस पे आप डाउनलोड कर सकते हैं. और सर आपने जो पूछा RTGS और NEFT से कैसे डिफरेंस है, RTGS NEFT एक टाइम पीरियड के बाद ही होता है, ये ऑनलाइन आपको तुरंत आ जाता है, इंस्टेंटली पैसा आ जाता है.
NEFT बैकएंड इट यूजेस IMPS फॉर
यस. और इसमें आपको पुल भी होता है, जैसे कि आप उसमें आप पैसा भेज सकते हैं, इसमें आप पैसा मांग भी सकते हैं. टिल नाउ इट इज 50 डिपेंड्स अपॉन बैंक, 50,000 के अंदर ही हम लोग कर रहे हैं अभी,
सिंगल ट्रांजैक्शन.
यस
सॉरी, वो RBI का सर्कुलर, आई थिंक दे हैव ऑलरेडी क्लैरिफाइड दिस इशू. मैं RBI का सर्कुलर आप देख लो, उसमें आई थिंक इट इज क्लियरली मेंशन. जब्त मतलब आपके इनकम टैक्स के कितने सीजर्स हुआ है? नहीं, उसका क्यूमुलेटिव जो है फिगर मेरे पास अभी नहीं है. इस पीरियड का भी फिगर मेरे पास अभी तुरंत अवेलेबल नहीं है. वो जब अप्रोप्रिएट टाइम है रेवेन्यू डिपार्टमेंट इसको दे विल शो इट. वन बाय वन. सॉरी,
द अमाउंट ऑफ मनी दैट वी हैव प्रिंटेड सो फार.
नो नो, आई थिंक इट्स एन ऑनगोइंग प्रोसेस. इट्स अराउंड द क्लॉक, एज आई मेंशनड अर्लियर. इट इज नाउ 24/7 ऑपरेशंस इन ऑल द करेंसी नोट प्रिंटिंग प्रेसेस एंड दे आर ऑल वर्किंग ऑन 3 shifts 7 days a week. And notes are being printed. These informations are usually not shared.
Let please.
You see, ATMs, as far as I know, I think almost a little less than 50% of the ATMs, I think if I have the number, I think out of the 2 lakh odd ATMs, I think more than
82,000 yesterday.
RBI. RBI has given a figure of 82,000 ATMs which have been recalibrated. So I think it is just a matter of another few days when all the ATMs will be fully recalibrated.
Sir, wedding ke liye kal ye kaha gaya tha ki us pe samiksha ki jayegi tamam RBI ne
usme raat ko kal clarifications unhone issue kar diye hain.
सर अगले एक हफ्ते के भीतर प्राइवेट कंपनी के एम्प्लॉई जो है उनको बड़ी संख्या में सैलरी आने वाली है, कैश जाहिर तौर पर ज्यादा निकालेंगे, इसके लिए क्या कोई तैयारी है? कंपनी क्या कैश में सैलरी डिस्बर्स करने का अलाउ करेंगे जैसे हमने गवर्नमेंट एम्प्लॉई
को?
इसी देखिए, सरकार ने ये जो है एक स्टेप गवर्नमेंट के तरफ से लिया गया है और हमारा ये उम्मीद है कि प्राइवेट सेक्टर कंपनीज भी अपने वो एम्प्लॉयज को जो है डिजिटल पेमेंट करेंगे. और कई बैंकों के चेयरमैन और MDs मेरे को बता रहे थे पिछले एक दो दिन में कि प्राइवेट कॉरपोरेट से भी अभी काफ़ी डिमांड फॉर वो जो प्रीपेड कार्ड्स और इम्प्रेस्ड कार्ड जिसका मैंने जिक्र किया था, प्रीपेड कार्ड्स के लिए कॉरपोरेट सेक्टर से काफ़ी डिमांड अभी बढ़ गया है. तो हम ये उम्मीद रखते हैं कि प्राइवेट कॉरपोरेट हाउसेज और कंपनीज़ भी अपने एम्प्लॉयज़ के जो बैंक अकाउंट है डायरेक्टली उनमें उनके खाता में वो डिपॉजिट कर देंगे और उसके अगेंस्ट में वो डेबिट कार्ड भी इशू कर सकते हैं.
इसे
नंबर्स आई वुड नॉट लाइक टू गो इनटू. इट इज फॉर रिजर्व बैंक ऑफ इंडिया बिकॉज प्राइमरीली एज यू नो करेंसी प्रोडक्शन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन इट्स यू नो इट इज monitored by the Reserve Bank of India. So I think as and when the figures are as and when you know it's for Reserve Bank of India to consider and you know give out the numbers when they you know as and when they feel the requirement.
Is the government planning to extend the exemptions which are currently available till 24th of November beyond that? And second, are you planning to completely remove over the counter exchange which was?
No, I cannot reply to that question now because if and when a decision is taken, it will be immediately announced.
How much money? North East states में कहा जा रहा है कि कई सारे ट्रेडर या उग्रवादी संगठन पुरानी करेंसी को बदलने में लगे हैं क्योंकि वहाँ पर टैक्स एग्जेम्प्शन ट्राइबल एरिया में मिला हुआ है. तो कुछ इस बारे में सर आप लोग कुछ कहें.
देखिए, कई सारे इलाके में कई सारे चैलेंजेस आए हैं. आप नॉर्थ ईस्ट के बारे में आपने कुछ कहा, ये चैलेंज हमको सिर्फ नॉर्थ ईस्ट में नहीं है, दिल्ली में अलग तरह के चैलेंजेस हमारे सामने आए थे. बहुत लंबे क्यू लग रहे थे, वही लोग बार बार आ रहे थे. सो डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ द कंट्री डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ चैलेंजेस एंड यू नो डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स द गवर्नमेंट इज फेसिंग. एंड जहाँ पे लॉ एंड ऑर्डर की बात हो तो वहाँ पे द कंसर्न सिक्योरिटी एजेंसीज एंड द लॉ एनफोर्समेंट एजेंसीज जो अप्रोप्रिएट स्टेप्स है वो तो लेंगे.
सर, सिंस 8th ऑफ नवंबर यू हैव एड्रेस्ड अस इन द प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंसेस एंड थ्रू अस टू द पब्लिक एंड द FM हैज स्पोकन इन पार्लियामेंट एज वेल एज PM हैज स्पोकन इन वेरियस फोरम्स. But there have been questions asked. You know, we do, your press conferences are informative and they are detailed. But why hasn't the RBI governor addressed anything in public? Why haven't other senior policymakers, including Mr. Lavasa or Madam Chittukul?
I think let's not. No. Let's not do these things. I think for communication purposes, it's irrelevant who addresses. So the idea is that government should communicate and give out all the information.
But as a regulator, it is necessary for this.
So it is not relevant. It's not relevant who speaks. I am just speaking on the behalf of the. You see, I am speaking on behalf of the government. I am not speaking here on in my individual capacity. So therefore, it is irrelevant whether I am speaking or somebody else is speaking.
Sir, you mentioned. एक सवाल सर, कैश, कैश सर बैंकों में, दिल्ली में सर का
अवेलेबल नहीं है.
बारह खंबा रोड में जो सर स्टेट्समैन हाउस है उसमें एक्सिस बैंक बहुत बड़ा ब्रांच है. कल 12 बजे दिन में कैश खत्म था. गांव में सर मैनेजर बता रहे हैं कि 2 लाख रुपए की सप्लाई आती है, 2 लाख रुपए.
नहीं देखिए, गांव की जब बात आप गांव की जो बात कर रहे हैं, अब हमारा सरकार का ये हाईएस्ट प्रायोरिटी है कि जो रूरल एरियाज है वहाँ पे भी कैश मतलब अवेलेबल किया जाए. परसों शाम को जब वित्त मंत्री जी ने ये वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंस किया था बैंकों के साथ, रिजर्व बैंक और सारे बैंकों के साथ, इसके ऊपर ये जो पॉइंट आप कह रहे हैं कि रूरल एरियाज़ में भी कैश अवेलेबल होनी चाहिए, उसके ऊपर बहुत प्राथमिकता दी गई थी, बहुत इंपॉर्टेंस दी गई थी. मंत्री जी ने ये सबको, बैंक्स और रिजर्व बैंक सबको एडवाइस किया हुआ है कि भाई आप और पोस्ट ऑफिसेस को भी कि आप ये स्टेप्स लीजिए कि रूरल एरियाज़ में कैश अवेलेबल हो. और रूरल एरियाज़ में मैं आपको बता दूं,
आप जो कह रहे हैं कि हो सकता है एक दो बैंक कहीं कुछ इलाके में शायद कुछ दिक्कतें आए होंगे, लेकिन बाई एंड लार्ज जो 155,000 पोस्ट ऑफिसेस है वो अभी एक्टिवेट हो गए हैं। रूरल एरियाज में रूरल ब्रांचेस, रीजनल रूरल बैंक्स और माइक्रो एटीएम्स भी काफ़ी अभी एक्टिवेट हो गए हैं। दी बैंकिंग कॉरेस्पॉन्डेंट के जो नेटवर्क है वो भी काफ़ी अभी एक्टिवेट हो गया है। तो रूरल एरिया में भी अभी जो जो मतलब कदम चाहिए वो ऑल दे हैव बीन टेकन एंड कैश इज बीन मेड अवेलेबल। आई थिंक वन मोर क्वेश्चन,
फॉरेन टूरिस्ट एंड स्पेशली फॉरेनर्स आर इन दिल्ली मेबी फॉर 6 मंथ्स और 7 मंथ्स, दे डोंट हैव बैंक अकाउंट, सो दे आर फेसिंग अ लॉट ऑफ इनकन्वीनियंस सर। Are you planning to do anything?
I take note of your suggestion. We will look at it. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.